I really can't believe he's gone. Hey, it's gonna be okay. Mike's just retired. He's not dead.
I know, I know. I just really wanted to see him hoist the cup with the Preds. Who's gonna be the captain now?
I know, I know. So many good choices, but you know what? I trust in the Preds to make the right choice. Here, have some milk. It always calms you down.
Thanks.
Can you believe it, Preds Nation? The last piece of the second line is gone, with news today that Mike Fisher has retired after 17 seasons. 10.5 with Ottawa, 6.5 with the Predators. I don't know where you all were this morning when you heard the news, but I woke up on the West Coast, turned on Braden Fitz, shout out 102.5 The Game, and it definitely woke me up. For many Preds fans, our connection with Mike Fisher began on February 10th, 2011, when Mike was traded from Ottawa to Nashville in exchange for a 2011 first-round pick and a 2012 conditional pick, depending on how many playoff rounds the Nashville Predators won in the spring of 2011. In a Players Tribune article written back in December by Mike that I will link to below if you haven't read it by now, Mike details that although there were many offers made for him, GM Brian Murray and owner Eugene Melnyk traded him to Nashville so that he could be closer to recently wed wife Carrie Underwood. Mike, the Preds, and fans everywhere wouldn't have to wait very long for him to make an impact on a team as he scored his first point, which was an assist on February 12th in a 5-3 win over Colorado. And on February 17th, he scored his first goal in a 3-1 win against the Vancouver Canucks. Both of those games came at Bridgestone Arena. Mike was the winner of the 2012 NHL Foundation Player Award, awarded to the player who applies the core values of hockey. They are commitment, perseverance, and teamwork to ensure the lives of those in his community. On June 26, 2015, prior to being able to become an unrestricted free agent, Mike would re-sign with the Predators one last time for a two-year, $8.8 million contract, $4.8 million for the 2015-2016 season, and $4 million for this last season. Mike's career high in points came with Ottawa during the 2009-2010 season when he reached 53 points. The highest he would ever reach with the Preds was 51 points. I don't know about the rest of you Preds fans. Feel free to comment below about your favorite Mike Fisher moment, but mine easily was May 5th, 2016, when in this very living room, at like 11 o'clock at night Pacific, I watched Mike Fisher scored the first ever Preds home overtime goal in triple overtime with 8:48 remaining in Game 4 against San Jose of the second round. Yes, the Preds would go on to lose to San Jose in 7, but if not for that goal, San Jose wins. Assumingly the Preds lose in 5 back in San Jose, I don't think they make the finals this year. So regardless, that was one of the biggest goals in this franchise's history to date. And that, Preds fans, leads us back to the beginning of Mike Fisher's time as captain, as after Shea Weber was traded to Montreal for P.K. Subban on September 7th, 2016, Mike Fisher was named the sixth captain in Nashville Predators history. I don't know who's going to be the next Preds captain. It probably won't be decided until next month during training camp. For those of you who don't know, the Preds have a thank you page to Mike if you wish to leave comments for him. I will link to that below this video as well. But seeing as Mike is the first Preds captain to retire as a Pred, I'd like to finish this video with my own tribute to him in my own way. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Oh, Captain, my Captain. Oh, Captain, my Captain.